Hi there, I'm Charles Nistor and I welcome you to this new episode on Swift. In this video, I am going to talk about strong reference cycles in Swift. Swift relies on automatic reference counting for managing the lifecycle of objects. With ARC, we don't have to manually release our instances, which is great. However, it does not solve all possible issues. A strong reference cycle occurs when two class instances hold the reference to each other, preventing ARC from releasing them. In the following demo, I am going to show you how easy it is to reproduce a strong reference cycle. We are going to implement two very simple classes called author and course. The author has public property called name of type string. Let's implement the initializer too, which accepts the name parameter. Next comes the course class. It has a title and an initializer too. So far we have two very simple classes. I am going to create two optional variables. Both are optional because we need to set them to nil to demonstrate the issue we'll soon have. Now I implement the dinit methods for both classes. We need them to track the deinitialization of the author and course instances in the console. Whenever an instance of these classes gets released, we'll see the corresponding message logged to the console. Alright, if we set the two instances to nil, we get the expected results. The dinit method is called for both objects, meaning that they were released as expected. Next, I'm going to add a new property to the author class. The courses array will hold all the courses created by a given author. I also add an author property to the course class. I'm going to also modify the course initializer so that it accepts an author argument. Whenever we initialize a course, it will be added to the list of courses for the given author. Remember, this is just an overly simplified example to demonstrate you the issue of strong reference cycles. Okay, let's make the required changes here too. You'll notice that something weird happened. The dinit methods haven't been invoked. This means that our objects have not been released, so basically we are leaking memory. To understand what happened, let's see this illustration. When we initialize a course, we pass an object of type author, so the course will keep a reference to the author instance. Then, in the course initializer, the course is added to the author object's list of courses. Now the author object holds a reference to the course instance. Both objects have a reference to each other. When we set the author to nil, the ARC engine will check whether there is an instance keeping a strong reference to the author object. Since the course object keeps a reference to the author instance, ARC won't release the author object until course is destroyed. Next, when we set the course object to nil, something similar happens. Since the author keeps a strong reference to the course object won't be released until the author is destroyed. This situation is what we call a strong reference cycle. To resolve a reference cycle, we have to prevent one of the classes from keeping a strong reference to the other class. We can achieve this by marking the author property as weak. Weak tells ARC that the course instance does not keep a strong reference to the author instance. Note that I had to make the property optional to make it weak. Indeed, we managed to break the circular dependency and both instances are released now. You should always carefully look for strong reference cycles. It is very easy to introduce memory leaks and they might go unnoticed until they produce several issues. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are interested in Swift-related videos. I plan to add new videos about interesting topics on a regular basis. Also, feel free to visit my website and check out my apps, my online courses, and other cool stuff. Best of luck!